going on, everybody? How are we doing today? So we're going to do the Deebot TA Plus through the pickup test. This is just like the Roomba 981 I did, where I put down 8 ounces of debris and went had to go clean on highest suction power, and then we came back and weighed the bin before and after to see exactly how much it has picked up. So the bin itself, empty, weighs 6.8 ounces, and then after the test is done, we'll reweigh the bin and see how much of that 8 ounces of material that I threw down it picked up. Now, I did the same exact test for the 981, and a commenter did catch me on something that I accidentally did was I forgot to take out the weight of the bowl. So the bowl itself weighs 0.4 ounces, so essentially there's 7.6 ounces of debris down. So we'll factor that in once we're done with this video. Now, there are a couple things I wanted to quickly talk about. The giveaway, sorry it's been delayed. I've been very busy, just haven't had time to put it all together. I will have it done this Saturday evening, probably around 6, 7 o'clock Central Time. And my plan is to go through my emails and print off every single person that got the correct code and sent it to me. And then I'll put them into like a jar or a box or something, and we'll pick it out and we'll do the winners for the 981 and the 692. So it's going to be very easy this way. It's going to be clean and cut, clear winner, and we won't have to worry about the software messing up or anything. Plus, it's going to be live, and you guys will be able to see me actually pick the winner. So I think that's a better way overall, and it makes things a lot easier. Let me show you the mess really quick. I just spread around Fruity Pebbles, Fruit Loops, a little bit of sand, and white rice throughout this entire area. I just grabbed it out of the bowl and kind of threw it up in the air. And of course it landed where it landed. So this is the same way I did the 981. And we will see how well this guy does. I think it's gonna do very good in this test. Hopefully it doesn't go crazy again. We'll see. I just have simple fake dog poop down. For whatever reason, in the last test with the obstacle avoidance, it literally sat on top of that and spun around, which is the complete opposite of what it's supposed to do. So hopefully it does not do that again, and we will find out when I do this test. So I'm going to send this guy out, and then we'll switch to the overhead view. And after it's done, we will weigh this out and see exactly how much this guy gets. I'm going to send him out. So you can see this is the map that it made from the obstacle avoidance. So once it goes this time again, the map should be even more complete, and then we'll rerun that test and see if there's any difference whatsoever.
Locating. Please wait.
I'll wait for you. So what do you think about this model, the TA Plus? Kind of curious about getting that N8 Plus Pro. I don't think I'd be interested in just the N8 Plus. I don't see it really having much of a difference at all over this one. But the Pro version should do a lot better on obstacle avoidance than this one overall. The Pro version is more like the AIVI that's currently out, right? Well, before that one. So what do you guys think? How do you think it's going to do on high suction power? Should do really well. And I emptied the bag. All right, took the bag out of the self-empty bin, so when it docks, it will not self-empty, and then we'll be able to weigh the bin. Let me know down in the comments, guys, what is your all-time favorite robot vacuum you've ever had? I think my next run for this room is going to be the Shark IQ, which should be very interesting. A lot of you know how I feel about that robot. And I think the results of these two different tests are going to prove exactly what I've been saying over the years of testing those robots. So far this guy is running fine. Last time when it did the obstacle avoidance, right around this carpet tile area, it collided with something that was down and completely threw it off. I think it was a Lego piece, a little Lego figure. I don't know why it just went around that white piece. That's pretty odd. I've never seen anything do that. Usually it's a black piece that'll mess up something, but So you should have, you know, came to this wall and just simply went down and back around and then filled in the area. So not sure exactly why it's doing this weird pattern. Anyways, I'm going to go in and switch to the upper view. And I'll speed this up for you guys, and then we'll see how well it does at the end. Hopefully it doesn't air out at all. It really shouldn't, since there's nothing to air it out. And hopefully you guys enjoy this video. If you do, smash that like button, consider subscribing. I have a ton of robot vacuums. This room is new, and I'm going to be doing all the other robot vacuums I have down here along with some. Everybody, the Deebot T8 Plus is done. As you can see, I made a new map, and I will run that obstacle avoidance test again after this. So the red light's only because I took the bag out so it would not self-empty, so we can weigh the bin and see how well it did with this test. So it took 39 minutes total. I believe that's what the app just said. And let's take a look around the room and see what debris that it left that we can clearly see. Then we'll go over and weigh the bin and see exactly how much it picked up of the 7.6 ounces. As you can see, it missed a jelly bean on the thick carpet, but you would think a jelly bean on thick carpet would be a lot easier than the thinner carpet, but it did miss it. Other than that, the thick carpet looks pretty good. There's some fruity pebbles here and there. Some fruity pebbles over here. It did really good on the tile. What I threw out looks to be completely gone. This floor looks pretty good as well overall. I did miss a jelly bean over there, and then there's some white rice and a little bit of fruity pebbles kind of all over this area. The carpet tiles, once again, looks decent overall, but you can see some fruity pebbles and some white rice as well, kind of all over. So not the greatest job on the thin carpet, but the thick carpet looks pretty good overall. This medium density carpet looks quite well. It did pretty good on the black runner, left a little bit, but there was a decent amount on there, but it got a good amount. And let's just go ahead and weigh it. You can see the bin is very full. Go over to my professional weighing system. And I'll try to convert this into grams. I'll throw it down as I edit this video. So the bin itself weighed 6.8 ounces. This is what the Roomba 981 did. The bin on that thing weighs a lot more because the little motor's on there. So let's see what this weighs after it did the test. So 13 ounces on the nose. So I picked up exactly 6.3 ounces out of the 7.6. So not too bad overall. Alright guys, so what do you think? For one pass, I'd say it did pretty good overall. So it's a good amount of debris to pick up with one pass. So most of the robot vacuums, after you actually make a map like this is completed now, you can tell it's a clean twice. So if I were to have this go clean again, I think it would absolutely get the full 7.6 ounces. It could be a future test if you guys really want to see that. But for now, I'm going to run them all on one simple cleaning run, and we'll see how well it does. Alright, if you enjoyed that video at all, please do me a big favor. Smash that like button. Consider subscribing. Got a lot more vacuums to do this with. So have an awesome day, and I'll see you in the next one.